Hi guys, and welcome to Heidi's Fish Tank. I wanted to talk a little bit about goldfish today. Goldfish are the world's most popular fish, and they are very, very misunderstood, unfortunately. At some point, most of us have probably owned a goldfish. My very first goldfish was when I was 3 years old, and of course, it was in a bowl, and we killed it. So I want to talk about why goldfish die so often and what you all actually need for goldfish, because they are more complicated than you think. Out of all the fish that I own, my goldfish actually take the most work. So all of us have an experience of having a goldfish, putting it in a bowl, and having the fish die pretty quickly, or maybe a small tank, that kind of thing. So there's a couple of things that you have to know about goldfish. Goldfish are descended from the carp family. They've been selectively bred for their colors, and then some of the fancy varieties are also selectively bred for their, you know, body shape and that kind of thing. Then there's also koi, which koi is a whole separate ball game. Koi get enormous. A lot of people think that goldfish are really delicate, and the truth is it's not necessarily that goldfish are delicate, it's that goldfish get very large, produce a large amount of waste, and a lot of people who get them don't know about the nitrogen cycle. So if this is your first fish ever, I would recommend that you watch my video about the nitrogen cycle, which is linked in one of these iCards and down below. I think that that's everyone should know what the nitrogen cycle is if you're going to be keeping fish. Most goldfish die because of ammonia burn or ammonia poisoning. Let's talk about what you actually need for a goldfish. So first I'll talk about the common goldfish and then I'll talk about fancy goldfish. It's a really commonly held myth that fish will only grow to the size of their tank. And it's a somewhat misconception. Fish will stunt, which means that yes, they will only grow as much as they have space for if their water quality isn't changed constantly. It's believed that goldfish release a hormone into the water, and in the wild, carp would do this in order to stunt the growth of other carp around them so that they can become the most dominant. But that stays in your tank, and it will end up stunting your own goldfish if their water quality is not constantly being changed. So it's true that your goldfish might not grow beyond the size of the tank, but when a fish is stunted, its insides continue to grow. So what often will happen is, yeah, you'll have a little goldfish, but its insides will grow and eventually it dies from the inside out because its insides grow too big for its body. So really, it's best to have them in a proper sized environment. Single tail goldfish get enormous. And the general thing that, and when I say single tails, I'm talking about the kinds that you win at carnivals, the feeder goldfish kind of thing. They're commons, comets, shabunkins, Chinkins, I think, are part of that family as well. Those things get enormous because they're a carp. And so a lot of times what people will say is 40 gallons for the first single tail goldfish and then 20 gallons for each additional goldfish. So if you have a 40 gallon breeder tank, you can have one of those feeder goldfish in it. One of those carnival goldfish can go in a 40 gallon tank. There are other people that will tell you that really the only appropriate place for those kinds of goldfish are a pond. Now, when I was a kid, we had a pond with single tail goldfish in it. And honestly, I wouldn't want to keep them in anything other than a pond as well. So there's a lot of like rules on the internet when it comes to tank size. But in my experience, when I'm actually testing the water of my goldfish tank and I'm looking at their level of waste, I can confirm that I think these numbers are accurate because I have four fancy goldfish in my 55 gallon tank, which I'll get to the fancy goldfish requirements in a minute. I have four fancy goldfish in my 55 gallon. And I have to do water changes, huge water changes, 50 to 70% water changes twice a week based on what my nitrate levels are reading. They just produce an enormous amount of waste and they get very, very large. So double tail goldfish, which are also known as fancy goldfish, the most common that you probably see at like Petco or PetSmart or that most people have are either going to be fan tails orandas, which are those ones that have the like bump on their head. It's called a wen. Or black moors, which are just a black version of a telescope eye. So they've got like the bubbly eyes. Those are what you'll see at your typical chain pet store, but there's all kinds of fancy goldfish. There's celestial eyes, bubble eyes, Ryukins, which are my favorite, telescope eyes. I mean, there's Ranchus, pearl scale. There are so many kinds. I'm sure lion heads, I'm sure I missed some in there, but there are so many kinds. Anything that has two tails, what you would expect is, this is probably a liberal number, 20 gallons for the first goldfish, and then 10 gallons for each additional goldfish, with the minimum being a 29 gallon, in my opinion, for one. So if you only have one, I wouldn't keep it in a 20 gallon. You could potentially do a 20 gallon long, which has the same footprint as a 29 gallon, but your water quality is not going to be as good. So I would prefer a 29 gallon over a 20 gallon because you need a lot of water to kind of reduce down that waste. So in my example, 20 gallons for the first goldfish, and then I've got 55. So 30, 40, 50. I have four goldfish in my 55 gallon tank, and I have to do water changes twice a week, and a lot of them. And my goldfish aren't completely full grown yet, and I'm running three filters on the tank. Goldfish need a lot more space than you think. They do get very, very large. Another thing that people don't necessarily know about goldfish is that goldfish are cold water fish. They are peaceful. They will eat anything that can fit in their mouth. So in terms of tank mates, you really don't have a lot of options other than other goldfish. You generally want to keep single-tail goldfish with other single-tail goldfish and fancy goldfish with other fancy goldfish because the fancy goldfish are not as good as swimmers as the single-tail goldfish. So they'll get outcompeted for food. So for tank mates, really, I think only other goldfish is preferable because they will eat anything that can fit into their mouth. So maybe you could have something like white clouds in there or other minnows, which are some cold water fish, but eventually the goldfish is going to get big enough that it'll fit in their mouth and that can kill one or both fish doing that. So for tank mates, I really don't recommend anything. Most things that you're going to see in the hobby are tropical fish, and so the temperatures aren't even proper to have a goldfish with those tropical fish. Now, goldfish can tolerate varying temperatures. They can go down very, very cold all the way to very warm, but those warm temperatures will increase their metabolism and will eventually lead to them probably dying sooner than they normally would. Goldfish can live for many, many, many years if they're properly taken care of. They don't just die in a week, typically. Typically, they die in a week because they're in an inadequate environment. Goldfish don't need a ton of height for their swimming room, so it's better to have wide, low tanks, which is why a 20 long actually would probably be okay in terms of footprint compared to a 29 gallon. They're not going to use that extra height very much, but the reason why I say 29 gallon for your first fancy goldfish is because that extra water volume is going to become very, very helpful for you. Goldfish are omnivores, but they need a lot of vegetable matter in their diet because they can easily become constipated. They're eating constantly, so they'll constantly beg for food. Another reason why goldfish often die is because they're often overfed. Because they look hungry all the time. If you overfeed your fish, it pollutes the tank and causes all kinds of problems. So in terms of food, you want something that is omnivore, vegetable based. There's lots of options that you can feed your goldfish. Personally, the stuff that I feed them are sinking pellets. I've heard some people say that you can do flake food. Personally, I prefer the sinking pellets because there's some theory that them gasping at the top causes them to swallow air, which can cause them to become floaty. I haven't seen anything to confirm that, but I figure the flake food, in my experience, pollutes the tank a little bit more. So I feed Northfin goldfish food, and then I also feed Omega-1 sinking veggie pellets. And then occasionally I will feed frozen spirulina brine shrimp. The shrimp will help kind of clean them out a little bit so they don't get constipated. And sometimes I'll feed vegetables, like actual vegetables like spinach or broccoli or peas, and nori, which is seaweed. Also, because they are omnivores, it can be hard to keep plants in their tank. I've tried duckweed, I've tried Java moss, I've tried Java fern, and they've eaten anarchists, they've eaten all of it. So that can be a little bit tricky because the plants would be very, very helpful with the goldfish to help kind of reduce the waste. I know that Life with Pets does pothos plants, which grows out of her filter, which seems to be working pretty well for her. So that's kind of cool. Another thing with goldfish is that they do require filtration, and I would do higher filtration than you would do with, like, say, tropical fish. I'm currently running a hang-on back filter on my 55 gallon, as well as two sponge filters on my 55 gallon in order to kind of keep up with the water quality. Filtration is required for any fish in order for there to be somewhere for your cycle to live. It is possible to do natural tanks, but with goldfish, I really would recommend filtration in order to have a place to maintain your nitrogen cycle. Again, say you won your fish at your carnival, you weren't planning on getting a fish, or you bought a fish and now you're stuck with the fish and you don't know what the nitrogen cycle is, I will have the video linked down below because I think that it's the first video that you should watch if you're going to have fish. Goldfish are also not huge jumpers, so you don't necessarily need to have a lid on the tank. A lid always helps. Any fish can jump, but it's not necessarily the first priority. They don't require any kind of special light. The light is so that you can see the fish. So say you've suddenly discovered that you are overstocked with your goldfish, you can take your goldfish and you can put it in something like a Rubbermaid bin and put the filter in that as temporary housing. You can get them, I've seen them as cheap as like $4 from Walmart, like very, very cheap. Some people do kiddie pools too, if they suddenly realize that they're overstocked with goldfish. And because they don't require a heater, that helps out too. And then eventually you can upgrade the tank. They're very clumsy, especially fancy goldfish, so I wouldn't do a lot of decor in their tank. In terms of substrate, it's not required. You don't have to have substrate, and especially because most people aren't going to be planting their goldfish tank, bare bottom is perfectly fine. It will help you with cleaning. But if you like the look of substrate, I would do a sand substrate over like a gravel because they do kind of like burrow in the sand looking for food and stuff. And the gravel they can choke on. So I have pool filter sand in mine, which is very inexpensive and is awesome in my opinion. I will also link down below the Solid Gold Goldfish channel if you want to know more about goldfish. She breeds goldfish and she's wonderful and she's a really, really good resource. But as with everything on the internet, this is my opinion. Don't take just one opinion and make it law. A lot of times people will see an opinion and then they will preach it and parrot it and call everyone else wrong for doing it differently. And ultimately it comes down to you're the only one that's gonna know what your stocking level should be. You're the only one that's gonna know what your water change schedule needs to look like for that particular fish and if the fish has enough swimming space. In this particular case, I really do think that the rules are adequate with goldfish. I really do think that you probably do want 20 gallons with the first one and 10 gallons for each additional one. And as always, bigger is always better. If this video was helpful, let me know. Give it a thumbs up. If you're new to the channel, be sure to hit the subscribe button and hit the bell next to the subscribe button so you won't miss any more videos. I will link down below. I kind of did like a clownfish 101 video and a betta 101 video, so I will link those down below. Check out any of my other playlists that might be interesting to you. Let us know down in the comments if you've ever had any kind of goldfish, and if you have, what kind it was. And I hope that I will talk to you all soon. Thanks for watching. Bye.